For 90 years, the Gulf Coast Research and Education Center has been using science to serve the needs of Florida farmers. Established in 1925, the original center was created to address disease pressures facing the tomato industry. But before long, researchers from the University of Florida's Institute of Food and Agricultural Sciences began tackling the challenges facing the state's other agriculture industries. Throughout the next 90 years, UF IFAS researchers used science to fight back against the pests and diseases attacking pepper, strawberry, and tomato fields. They developed a new technique for growing crops using raised bed and plastic mulch. This technique was so successful that it's now used throughout the world. They discovered how to extend the growing season using protected agriculture tunnels. And they taught farmers how efficient drip irrigation systems were to save money and reduce water use. In 2005, the center relocated to a new 475-acre state-of-the-art facility in Baum, and the work continued. Breeding programs generated hundreds of new varieties of strawberries, tomatoes, and ornamental plants. These new varieties increased the yields for growers and improved flavor for consumers. Farmers in Florida and around the world now grow thousands of acres of these new varieties every year, making it possible for farmers to stay in business and for people to stay healthy. The tomato breeding program at the Gulf Coast REC continues to support Florida's $500 million a year tomato industry. UF IFAS researchers are using technology to identify the genes linked to favorable traits in tomato plants. Scientists can then combine traits like disease resistance and increased yields with traits for flavor and higher levels of nutrients to create new varieties that are better for farmers and consumers. Throughout the years, the tomato breeding program developed many new varieties, but the most popular is the Tasty Lee. This fresh market tomato grows well in the Florida environment and offers consumers superior flavor and high levels of the antioxidant lycopene. This brand name tomato can now be found on store shelves across the state. But one new variety isn't enough. Everyday tomato growers like Tony Damari are facing challenges from new pests and new diseases. It's one of the reasons that Damari is working closely with GCREC researchers to help develop new varieties to meet the industry's changing needs.
Without the center and bomb, we as growers cannot survive. We need to continue developing varieties that are better for the producer and ultimately better for our buyers and consumers.
Thank you so much. You have a great day.
For 60 years, researchers at the Gulf Coast REC have been improving strawberries too. Research began at the Strawberry Laboratory in Dover before moving to the new center in Baum. Over the years, UF IFAS research has increased the size of the berries and shortened the production time, allowing growers to cash in on higher prices at the beginning of the season. And today, 85% of Florida's 11,000 acres of strawberries are varieties developed at GCREC. Now researchers are focused on improving the flavor of the berries to help growers like Carl Grooms.
Those guys have come up with some good varieties here right recently, and one of them is the Radiance, and that's been paramount here in the state of Florida and worldwide. And here in the last few years, they've come up with this number 27, it's called, but us growers call it the Sweet Sensation. And we looked at it might revitalize the whole industry.
UF IFAS researchers also developed a monitoring system that can predict when a disease outbreak is likely to occur.
And everything that they work on is very essential for what we do. And without them doing that, I think that this whole thing would just melt down around us. The bottom line is we probably wouldn't be in an industry here if it had not have been for the research and development that the university system has put in on behalf of our strawberry industry.
As the Gulf Coast Research and Education Center celebrates its 90th anniversary, UF IFAS scientists are looking toward the future. Researchers are already learning to grow new alternative crops like blackberries, hops, and pomegranates to give farmers new ways to make money. They're testing new fumigation systems to better manage weeds and kill soil-borne pests and pathogens. And they're focused on finding varieties of traditional crops that can be mechanically harvested to reduce labor costs. The next 90 years will bring more changes and more challenges. And the Gulf Coast REC is ready to use science to help farmers and Florida residents be better prepared for the future.